If you have an iPhone or iPad, you're going to love this technique. The new iBooks app allows you to view PDFs, but it's not very easy to get them there. This tip will give you a new option when you save your PDFs to save them directly into iTunes. This is an intermediate level tip, not hard to do, but we boldly go where you've never gone before. Go up to the File menu and create a new Finder window. Go to your Applications and find iTunes. Either right-click on it or hold the Control key down on your keyboard so that you get a pop-up window, and choose Make Alias. It'll make a second copy of iTunes, but notice that it has this little black arrow. It's not really iTunes, it's just a pointer file pointing at the real one. Right now the name is in a blue outline and in blue, and it's waiting for us to change the name. I'm going to change this to what we're actually going to see on the menu. Save PDF to iTunes. And I'll hit return to accept the name, and it re-alphabetizes it. Now, I'm going to go back up to the File menu again and open up another Finder window. And in this one, I'm going to go to the Library. Look for your home folder on the left. Yours, mine says Training, but yours is going to have your name on it. And there's a Library folder. Now, normally, I don't recommend going into this folder, but this is one of those opportunities when we can use it. When you're in there, look for a folder under the P's that says PDF Services. Now, I don't see it, so I'm going to make a new folder. I'm going to go up to File and say New Folder, and I'm going to type in PDF Services. Make sure it looks exactly like this, capital PDF space capital S Services. And then I'm going to take my Save PDF to iTunes icon and drop it in PDF Services. And I'll close those windows. Now, when I have a file that I want to save as a PDF, to move it into my iPhone or iPad, I'll go up to the File menu and I'll choose Print. Now, if your print window is not big like this, you can hit this little blue button. I always recommend leaving it big so that you have all of your print options. And down in the lower left-hand corner, there's a button that says PDF. And when I drop it down and scroll down to the bottom of it, there's a new item that you just created called Save PDF to iTunes. And I'll click on it. And now, when I look in my iTunes, on my device, under Books, you can turn on the sync, and there's the file that you just created. In this way, you can choose which of the files you want to synchronize or not with your iPhone or your iPad.